Millionaires, billionaires, they're all around the world. But can you imagine achieving the billionaire status when you're 30? Whether it was hard work starting a business, or they just have an ultra-wealthy family behind them, these billionaires made this list for a reason. And if you're close to 30 and you think you haven't done anything important in life, don't worry, you still have time to become a billionaire. Just follow these people's steps. Curious to find out who they are? Well, without further ado, here are the 10 youngest billionaires in the world. Number 10, Bobby Murphy. Starting off the list with one of the co-founders of the ultra-famous app Snapchat, Bobby Murphy, together with his friend, Evan Spiegel, created the app when they were just students at Stanford University. Since the app was created, it became hugely popular, especially among teens, for the disappearing messages, the cute filters with ears, and the photos and videos with captions that will also disappear. To this day, over 229 million users are using this app, which made Murphy go up into the billionaire list. Acting as the chief technology officer over in Snapchat Incorporated, he and Spiegel together own the third of the company, and Murphy is one of the few in this list that are considered to be self-made billionaires. With Snapchat becoming a phenomenon back in 2012, and still to this day is at the top 5 most used apps among teens, this only meant one thing for Murphy, and he just kept climbing up his way to the billionaires list. Number 9. Patrick Collison. Born in Ireland as the eldest of 3 kids, he's an entrepreneur and a CEO and co-founder of Stripe. This financial services and software company was created by Patrick himself, together with his brother John. This organization lets companies and people take delivery of payments over the internet, becoming a huge hit that it made both of the brothers billionaires with at least $3.2 billion each. Back in the day, Patrick took his first ever computer course at the age of 8 at the University of Limerick, and then he began learning computer programming at the age of 10. He became quite good at programming, so much so that at the age of 16, he even won the 41st Young Scientist and Technology Exhibition in 2005. Both him and his brother came to the idea of creating a payment app while they were in college, and after working long and hard on it, in 2013, they founded Stripe. Number 8. Evan Spiegel. We already talked about one of the co-founders of Snapchat, but the other co-founder made the list also. Spiegel is the CEO of the company that we previously mentioned and is owned by both Bobby Murphy and Spiegel. That earned him the title of the youngest billionaire in the world in 2015. Born and raised in Los Angeles, California, he attended and graduated from Stanford University, and he even had an unpaid internship in sales at Red Bull. In 2011, while studying product design at Stanford, Spiegel proposed an idea for an app, which most of his classmates ridiculed about. Later on this same year, working together with Bobby Murphy and Reggie Brown, they launched a prototype for Peekaboo, which was later renamed Snapchat. The app became a huge hit once it launched in 2012, and by the end of the year, Snapchat already had 1 million active daily users. Number 7. John Collison. Patrick Collison's younger brother comes at the 7th place on this list. You already know that he's the co-founder of Stripe together with his brother, but did you also know that he's a president of the company? They started working on the app all while John was analyzing physics at Harvard. The company is aiming to make accepting payments online easier and extra inclusive. But besides Stripe, John also co-founded Automatic, which was once received with the air of Live Current Media. After the now San Francisco-based company Stripe raised $150 million from Capital G, both John and his brother Patrick became one of the youngest self-made billionaires in the world. And if that wasn't enough, John was also ranked by Forbes in 2016 as the 15th in the list of America's richest entrepreneurs under 40. As of 2020, his net worth is considered to be a shocking $3.2 billion. Number 6. Jonathan Kwok. After the death of his father, Walter Kwok, the former chairman of Hong Kong's biggest developer, Sun Hung Kai Properties, both Jonathan and his older brother, Jeffrey, inherited their late father's stake in the company in 2018. They took over Empire Group Holdings, a property developer his father started right before he died. Jonathan took over the director's chair in Empire Group Holdings and is overseeing the group's real estate investments, as well as project developments and asset management operations. Before he even inherited this position, he worked as a trading desk analyst and also as a consultant and an associate at a few companies. He graduated at Cornell University, and at the age of 28, he has definitely accomplished more than we ever did. Being so young and successful is definitely the reason why he finds himself on the list of the youngest billionaires in the world. Number 5. Anna Kasprzak. On the list of billionaires, we should definitely include Anna Kasprzak. This Danish dressage rider really pushed herself with her talent and hard work and made herself a way to the top. But don't get it confused, not all of her success is due to the dressage riding. Being the younger sister of Andre Kasprzak, this lady holds a large percentage of the Danish shoe brand Eco, owned by none other than the CEO, her mother. Her own success is due to the love for horses, that she even made it to the Olympics quite a few times. She represented Denmark twice in the Summer Olympics, with her best result being the fourth place with a Danish team in the 2012 Summer Olympics. As for individual results, the best she ever got was at 14th place in 2016. She has won multiple championships and World Cups, and has been part of many team championships while representing Denmark. Number 4. Gustav Magnar Witzoe. Born and raised in Norway, this billionaire comes at number 4 due to the company his father owns. His father, Gustav Witzoe, is a founder of a huge fish farming industry, or company in Norway, called SalMar AS. The title billionaire came when his father gave Gustav 50% stakes of the company. The company made huge profits and is doing incredibly well, according to Wikipedia and Polytoo. This 27-year-old has an estimated net worth of $3.2 billion, all being a direct result of the family's salmon empire. But other than working at his father's company, he's also a technology startup and property investor. He's previously worked for an MGM property that has invested in both Gopi and Key Butler. And as of lately, he's doing some modeling on the side, doing photo shoots and music videos, as well as commercials for various brands. Number 3. Katharina Andresen. Counting down to number 3, we have the heiress of Norway, and according to Forbes, as of 2020, she has an estimated net worth of $1.1 billion. Her father, Johan H. Andresen, the owner of Ferd AS, made the title billionaire possible for Katharina by transferring 42.2% ownership stakes each to her and her sister. So, as far as the family inherited money goes, she definitely deserves this place. Coming from a long line of business people, with being the great-great-great-granddaughter of Nikolai Andresen, who was a merchant and a banker. Being a business person is definitely in her blood, and hopefully she'll continue down this path. Both her and her sister are both on the top of the youngest billionaires in the world, and we hope it stays that way. As of 2019, she stated that she would move to London, but other than that, we don't have any personal information about her life. Number 2. Alexandra Andresen. Following Katharina, in second place we have her 12 months younger sister Alexandra. She became the world's youngest billionaire at the age of 19 in 2016, and as of 2020, her estimated net worth is the same as her sister's, with $1.1 billion. As we mentioned previously, she made the title billionaire from her father's company, Ferd AS, when in 2007, he transferred ownership of 42.2% to both her and her sister Katharina, even though his father didn't force them to take part in the company if they didn't want to. Other than the family business, Alexandra has also been interested in horse dressage competitions. She has won multiple awards and honors, but other than that, she never made it a full-time profession. She has also been into modeling for a bit, and every now and then for a clothing company called Kingsland. Number 1. Kylie Jenner. Finally, at number 1, we have the one and only TV personality, Kylie Jenner. We've all heard about the Kardashian-Jenner family by now, given the fact that the show Keeping Up with the Kardashians has over 10 seasons. But the youngest of them all blew up the internet when she decided to launch her own makeup line. Selling out with every single collection, Kylie was climbing up the billionaire world pretty fast. She is, to this day, the world's youngest billionaire in the world. With being the owner of Kylie Cosmetics, she owns 100% of the stake in the company. Apart from her own makeup company, she also owns part of the Kendall Kylie line that she launched with her older sister, Kendall. In 2019, when she was just 21 years old, Forbes announced her to be the number one self-made billionaire, and the fact that she was so young was just a plus for her. On a related note, we wanted to know, did you guess who would make it at number one? Let us know in the comment section below. If you'd like to see more amazing videos such as this one, make sure to like this video, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss any of them. And as always, thanks for watching, guys.